Yugen Dynasty on the blue, BMGaming on the red. Immediate Liliana taken away. That is a direct ban from Ahoon saying, no, sir, you're not getting the Fox Lady yourself. Florentino as the rebuttal.
Interesting. BMGaming were so sure they didn't need to ban any of the OP characters last time. They were so sure that they could let Elsu through, Florentino might get through. We don't care. We'll win a guarantee this time. All of a sudden, BMGaming think, maybe we'd best play it safe.
Especially if it's going to be Hitman who's going to be playing that OP character. So I would like to see them ban Richter as well. Hitman can cause them lots of problems, like he showed with Azuka last game.
Very good in the sideline. This Elsu comes through. BMGaming not sure they can play it. That may mean they have to ban out three powerful characters here, as Yugen Dynasty are just still target banning.
And I think that's the right strategy to go for Yugen Dynasty. They're not scared. I like it, Jump and TJ. They're not scared of BMGaming. They're going to take it to them.
So now, last ban away for Yugen Dynasty. It's going to be the Teamy. Don't want to have to worry about it for anybody. Now BMGaming gets the final decision on where they want to go. Obviously, they can go with something like the Richter or the Sephira. The Richter seems to be the hover here. 7 seconds left to go on what they decide.
If they lock in this Richter, BMGaming is fully admitting defeat. Okay, look at that. They save some dignity.
They do. Annette gets taken away, so Yugen gets the decision. Sephira or Richter?
I guarantee you now, this dignity is going to be rammed back down BMGaming's throat because they've now let Yugen Dynasty get Sephira.
Yep,
BMGaming needs to pick Richter here because Hitman's Richter is too good. So, yeah. Once this goes through, though, that means that MTS might not be able to get the Superman that he wants.
Ibeneth now seems to be the hover for BMGaming. Richter locked in as you wanted. And is it an Ibeneth? It is.
So Triumph is a player who's played in the Vietnamese leagues. And in the Asian meta, especially a few months ago, Ibeneth was far more popular than he is in the West. The major thing they were using him for was these engage plays. You can send the Ibeneth at the enemy team, spend Nature's Realm, and you just basically force a team fight.
So what does Yugen Dynasty do on the rebuttal? Lumber gets locked in for their support position, and then Talonis as well.
Lots of poke coming out here for the side of Yugen Dynasty, Sephira and Talonis. Liking it so far.
Oh, do this.
Oh, is this what we're going to have now? Oh, it's a Wirral lock-in as well as a Tulin.
So here's my prediction, and I may be crazy.
Well, we all are, to an extent.
I bet MTS has been playing this Wirral, and he personally wants to play it. The only other option for me is that the Ibeneth goes to side lane and we see Wirro put in the support role, which for some NA players were believing it.
Right. For those of you unaware, the Ibeneth and Wirro are both flex. They can both play support or the side lane, so it's up in the air where they're going to put these heroes.
Preda and Rourke are now locked in, so you've got Rourke with the engage, you've got Preda with the backline threat, and then a Violet to round out the composition for BMGaming, putting in the jungle there.
Yo, fam, this is wild.
So, Sephira side lane.
Yes.
Prey to mid.
Uh-huh.
Confusion.
So Lumber 100% support, because he's being played by Chickadon.
Yes.
So, yes, Hitman will be playing
chicken,
the Sephira.
Chicken.
Mm-hmm. Got it. Check. Monday will be on the Rourke in jungle. He's got his work cut out for him against Violet being played by Basic. It will be Wirro in the side lanes and Ibeneth on support.
I do like the Rourke, though, even though, like you mentioned, you're going against the Violet. What he's really going against is this fortress composition. And how do you bust a fortress composition? You just bust through the front door. You kill the tree standing in your way. Ibeneth will have a hard time.
How do we feel about this Preda, though? We haven't really touched upon this as much because Sly played a very good Sephira in the last game. Does Preda answer the questions is Preda the answer to the composition of BMGaming?
It seems like a comfort pick because he's tried to force Preda in the past. The game that we saw Preda from Sly before, it was against an Elsu, and I almost cried, and it was very bad. Hopefully he can actually play a decent game this time because he's not going against an Elsu.
I want to talk about the Wirro, though, because we haven't seen that.
Yeah, let's talk about
the Valor series.
Let's talk about, so we've got some new viewers constantly coming into the Valor series. Wirro being a more unconventional pick, clearly being the first time he's been picked here in Season 3. Talk about him.
Okay, the most exciting thing about Wirro is he does have a resurrect, basically, built into his kit. When he dies, he'll go into a little, like, is cocoon's the right word? Stasis.
Something.
He's having a think. And he'll sit there for a while, and when he resurrects at the end of it, he heals his team.
Yes. But if you catch him out, then he just dies because you kill him again.
Yes.
Is the Ibeneth, though, going to be enough of the engage to tackle on the back line of the Preda?
So my theory is that they are just going to use this Yubenith like an Asian Yubenith, which means he's going to be setting up very aggressively into the enemy jungles and then popping the Nature's Realm. And then should things go sideways, they're relying on the heal from the Wyrrha Resurrect to be that almost second support for the team.
But taking a look, though, at the damage threat that you have from, or the damage threat that you have specifically on the side of Yugen Dynasty, is it not a little bit of a worrisome when you think about that? You've got the Preda, which we all know what happens in the late game. You've got the Rourke, and we've seen Rourke already dominate today as well. Does that create a question mark for BMGaming?
I have huge question marks for BMGaming, and I think they lost this draft terribly. And I think if this wasn't, the second team going against the fifth team, then it would just be a complete walkover for Yugen. The only thing that prevents me from saying that is because is Yugen really going to 2 OBM?
We don't know yet. I mean, that is too early to tell, because what I will give BMGaming credit for is, remember, they are some of the most mechanically skilled players in the Valor series thus far, and they are on heroes that, if executed appropriately, specifically we talked about Triumph on his Yubenith. We've got the others as an opportunity. It's a question that we need to have answered. And the guys, it's going to get answered right now. TJ, D2, it's time for game number 2 of our first match for North America. Yugen Dynasty up one game over BMG.
And it will be insane either way, because both teams are running a little bit out of the meta, to say the least.
Right. Of all the crazy heroes, though, I actually look at the top lane. Hitman is going to have his work cut out for him against a Richter in the top lane. If he wins that matchup or even takes it to a standstill, then he is a god.
Invade will come through early. Chicken has to use the Rampage to stun up Hoon. And Hitman, like you say, is having a lot of trouble to deal with TH.
I have played this specific matchup in this lane because I love playing Sephiroth. I'll play her even the side lane. It's tough, TJ.
Okay, I want to talk to something Jump was talking about, though. He said he was asking a lot of questions about the engage onto the back lines. There are a lot of... Ooh, Hitman, that's trouble.
That's an engage.
He was talking about the engage. There are a lot of players on Yugen Dynasty that want to sit in the back lines. Dual Spiral, Sly. Can BMGaming reliably get to them?
It comes down to TH and Hoon.
Yeah.
And Hoon, if anyone's going to be on a squishy mage and get back there, it's going to be Hoon.
Triumph will encounter some trouble. He's got that healing. Will it keep him alive? No. Monday walks up close range and delivers a crossbow to the heart.
Oh, if Yugen Dynasty can continue to do this and continue to win these early game skirmishes, they could repeat game number 1.
Their problem is what you highlighted, the top lane. Hitman's already started struggling. I think he'll be far less killable once he gets his Tide of Life going, but he simply doesn't have the wave clear.
Right, and Hitman is a very aggressive player. That's what makes him so good. The thing is, if he over-aggresses, then he's going to get caught out, especially if Hoon continues to rotate over there and give some help.
Monday will join Dual Spirals for this Abyssal Dragon tank. BMGaming dual players nearby, MTS in particular, will be looking for a full engage if he can, but he's just bullied back. Monday's low. They're gone. BMGaming able to pick up a kill, and Chicken has to back off. The Abyssal Dragon does go to Yugen Dynasty. Dual Spirals was able to grab it in the scrim, but... the Mind Golem, a lot of jungle is going back to BM.
Right, Yugen Dynasty, they spent too much of their effort trying to take the Abyssal Dragon rather than focusing on the side of BMGaming. There's so many shots, TJ, that went into the dragon rather than going into their opponents. And even though they got it in the end, they were taking damage the entire time.
Dual Spirals in trouble as well as MTS shows up as new love. A deep dive behind the tower, that is something Wyrrha can do.
Exactly, with those empowered auto attacks, he can just get in there and knock you up. But I am very surprised he's able to make this work so far.
Perhaps a disconnect coming through from Sly as he's sitting back in the base. I hope he's able to resolve that network issue.
Right, we haven't seen him for quite a while, so hopefully he's able to come back.
No pulls called by Yugen, which probably means they're sorting it out. They're going to have to play pretty...
If I'm Yugen, I call pause right now. I mean...
Yeah. They're scattered across the map, but they are just playing defense, and they're directing this mid farm over to Monday, which is the best choice they could have.
Apparently, they've already used the pause. They have no pauses remaining to be able to pause here. That is very unfortunate for them.
Because they had those tech issues at the start, they spent their pulls for the game, which is rough, to say the least.
Even 4v5, though, they're picking up kills.
Yep, they do get that kill in mid. They'll just have to hope. MTS in the meantime.
Oh, building up his ult.
Oh, but wow. It goes Black Monday. Does take a little bit of shift. That's a good Earth Splitter, though. They have the revenge. Yugen Dynasty winning the 4v5. Do grab CH.
What is happening? He goes in Slides for the flicker.
Back.
He's back right in time. Oh, imagine if he was there the entire time. They would have so much more gold in their coffers.
They don't need him. He's extra.
They will need him eventually. He has 0.9k gold. He's going to have to get some gold pretty soon. They need to give a little bit of a...
They need to... BMGaming need a freebie. Otherwise, there's no way they have a hope in this game.
I don't think that's what they're thinking, but we're going to go with it.
Dude, don't send me angry tweets. I'm joking.
This is astonishing, honestly, that the fact that they didn't have a hero with them for this long,
yeah,
and they're still in this game.
Hats off to Yugen. It is really unfortunate they're having these technical issues repeatedly, by the sounds of it, on Monday or on Sly, and it is insane that they made it work. A dive in the jungle, though. Dual spirals will go down. Hey, Sly's moving. Dual spirals does fall, though, and that means that Yugen Dynasty have to start turning things around as Hoon dives forward. The mid tower will fall. Try and pops the Nature's Realm. Sly has to leave. He's not doing enough damage. And Chicken, I don't think even he can rampage out. He will get up. The Earth Splitter, it keeps Basic at bay. He survives off the back of excellent play.
Wow, Chicken, I can't believe he stayed alive there. But looking at Sly, it looks like he's still having issues. He's not really moving that quickly. I know it's a Preda, and I know his movement isn't the greatest other than his passive, but. It's difficult, TJ. It's difficult.
Yeah, he's definitely going to have a rough game to catch back up, but Yugen do resolve their technical issues from the looks of things.
I think Hitman might be dead, though.
Hitman's in trouble. He has Tides of Life. That'll keep him up. There's so many BM Gaming members here. Padiz juke the ball. The tower falls, but he stays up.
All right, at least he's able to stay alive. At least he's able to continue farming here.
This is so smart.
Yeah.
Yugen, I love it.
They should just train with four members because this is the way they should be playing
like
all the time.
Lifting weights.
Exactly. They should play this way all the time.
Not calling Sly dead weight. I'm saying it's like weight training, altitude training.
Exactly. The fact that they've had to play this way because they're down a member, if only they play... Okay, I don't want to, you know...
If they played like they have for the first 6 minutes of this game, every game,
exactly,
they would be the top team in the Valor series.
Exactly. They played amazingly so far, and I want to see this all the time. So let's practice some 4v5s.
They've been 4v5, and the gold lead for BM is 2,000 at 6 minutes. That's actually crazy.
Right. 2,000 is a standard lead. It's not even that much. The other team is very much in it. In normal situations.
Oh, Thunderbird down bottom. Triumph does get caught out. He'll be traded out with another pickup. There's a nice pickup to Sly. However, Hitman's in a lot of trouble in the lane, and at Basic, we'll be able to dive past and get him plus tower.
You see the power of a Rourke against Yebaneth, though. He can just stand through that Nature's Realm and get him.
Into Monday. Can he stay alive through it? There's the Determination popped. And an excellent Earth Splitter. Chicken, you're nuts.
Chicken is OP indeed. Oh my god.
He's a rooster, Daniel. A fine peacock. His plumage extends for days.
Chicken, that was amazing. And if they continue to do this, then perhaps they can come back in the seemingly unwinnable game. Oh.
His feathers are used to craft the arrows of gods.
I suppose.
That was a really sick support play, and it wasn't the first we've seen this game from Chicken.
It certainly wasn't. Yugen Dynasty, even though it's been amazing that they've stayed in the game, they have the work cut out for them. There's a second team in the league, TJ, and it's going to be very difficult for them to catch up here.
Monday has to be a focus here because he's still doing all right. And if he can find good engages onto the 1v1s, they have a path very much into this game.
Yugen Dynasty have the gold on the right heroes. They have it on Monday on the Rourke. They have a dual spiral on the Tel'Nas. That is going to be the major damage source, and the waves are going to get back in the game and start winning these teamfights.
Abyssal Dragon up for grabs again. All of them so far have gone to Yugen Dynasty. They'll try and make that a third, so they dive in. Basic is in trouble.
Oh, the Plague Spectre! It's beautiful! Dual spirals get killed. Try himself to focus down, and the tide of life is there! Yugen Dynasty get two more kills at a critical mid lane bound.
TJ, they're doing it! They're doing it! And now they get to rotate over to their waves. They took a major risk to take that fight.
TH will go in 1v4!
No, he can't do it! You can't do it, especially against a Sephiroth!
They are falling apart against BMGaming, but I want to credit Yugen Dynasty so much. They've kept this game alive for so long, and now they're finally reaping the benefits of it. Now they can finally rotate to the lanes and play on a fair battlefield.
And they don't go for the Abyssal Dragon, instead stepping back and focusing down a Dark Slayer instead.
Yeah, who cares about the Abyssal Dragon when you can take the major objective, TJ? That Abyssal Dragon isn't enraged yet. They only want the angry one.
The Abyssal Dragon will get taken in return for BM Gaming, but it's just going to give them gold if they get it, whereas Yugen Dynasty already have a Drake they can summon.
I love the calm, composed, measured response here from Yugen Dynasty. They don't care that the Abyssal got taken. Yes, they're falling behind a little bit in gold, but that's okay. They have the momentum in this game. They have control in the minds of BM Gaming. They're shook, TJ.
Shook it.
Shook it to the max. BM Gaming don't know what to do. They could even get ahead, or at least far enough ahead, when they had a 5v4.
They don't anymore. We've gotten past that. Yugen Dynasty have all but evened up the gold lead, given how late we are in the game.
And that's a problem, because Sly's actually going to be doing damage now.
Yep. Sly doing a great job. Triumph caught out. Oh, they don't quite have it. Sly will arc through a little bit of a Plague Spectre, but it goes wide. It doesn't really matter, because they can focus down the core, or the tower, rather. TH will back off, unable to clear a wave himself. This tower will crumble.
They're continuing to push through these towers, and they can take them so quickly because they have the Rorik and they have the Telenos.
Watch the flanks. TH, MTS, both playing the side flanks. And look at what Yugen Dynasty are doing. They're checking them, but they haven't found TH. And he's waiting for an opportunity to dive out on Sly. Essence of the Wind. It's perfect. The support play is beautiful from Chicken. He holds the line. MTS is back, though, and he'll get two. Hitman and Sly both gone. The second flank works, so Yugen Dynasty drift back. They can't take the fight, so they take the enraged Abyssal Dragon.
They do take it, TJ, but because Monday wasn't there, that's why they lost two members. I think they needed to continue to stay focused, stay grouped, because if they're against BM Gaming, they know BM Gaming want a fight. I think they should stay as five. I know it sounds crazy. I know that macro is key, but against BM Gaming, I think they needed to invite these fights and then take them out.
I really, really like what they managed to do, though. Yeah. Mm. Maybe they could have won that fight itself, but it was going to be rough either way, and at most they get a tower from it. They certainly wouldn't have felt fully empowered to take that Enraged Abyssal. The fact that Yugen Dynasty, even off of a loss, managed to grab the Enraged Abyssal means that BM Gaming get literally nothing for winning that team fight, and arguably much more goes in favor of Yugen Dynasty.
And they really want a bush party right here.
Yeah, Triumph low up on the side. There was a little bit of poke coming in from TH, but he wasn't able to find a kill.
Let's take track of the situation here. It's about a 2,500 gold lead for BM Gaming. They have the tower advantage 8 to what looks like 5. But the Dark Slayer, excuse me, the Abyssal buff is on the side of Yugen Dynasty. Can they make this work?
Tides of Life forced from Hitman won't be available in this next fight. Monday's chasing down Hoon, though. It's just the Terminator. He keeps going. Earth Splitter's there. Monday finally gets caught out. The Essence of the Wind can't keep alive. Dark Blessing can, but MTS pushes him out. That's a good kill. And actually, more will follow as Chicken himself is knocked low. Hitman's gone, and they don't have revenge as the towers fall. TH takes a high ground. Dual Spirals had to play defense.
Monday was so thirsty for that kill. He saw the opportunity, but unfortunately, that's Hoon, TJ. He's going to be able to disengage, and unfortunately, he can't get it, and the team fell behind him.
Sly is doing so much damage, though.
He finally is. He's finally got some farm to his name. He has 6,000, went straight for the damage. After the Orb of the Magi went to the Boomstick so that he could immediately get the damage out on the other side.
TH, Mark of the Hunter. He's got two, but he can't finish it. And Dual Spirals turns it. Absolutely done. BM Gaming down a player. Can't keep pushing.
TJ, that's huge. That is absolutely huge. If he gets that kill, even if he dies, it's even now. Yugen Dynasty have a chance to get back into this game, back once more, and start to punish BM Gaming for their over-aggression.
Hoon will back up. BM Gaming are taking advantage of the fact that there's just this four-man core here.
Slides low.
He's charging up the ult. Oh my goodness!
Wow.
Hoon's there to follow up, and Triumph's got the full Nature's Realm. That actually might be game. It's only Hitman on defense.
That has to be game, TJ. It was a spirited fight by Yugen Dynasty, but I think BM Gaming is pushing on the core now.
Beautifully done by MTS. He wins the fight, and Hitman's got a tall task ahead of him. 20 seconds on the respawns, and Wave arrives now.
He does have Tide of Life, but there's so much damage coming in.
He must clear like two waves in order to save this game. He'll go in, lots of damage his way. Tide of Life does keep him up, but he'll fall to the four-man focus, and the core itself follows. BM Gaming take game number two, stepping back up against a very good look from Yugen Dynasty.
BM Gaming, they set things straight, at least for themselves. It was a struggle, but they finally take down Yugen Dynasty.